Hello. I know you all haven't seen me in a while. First things, my mom is, she went back into the hospital on the 23rd of November. She's now back in for the second time into a rehab. Physically, she's doing better. She has to regain her mobility to walk again. Well, to walk and get up and stuff again, but she can sit up. Last time she was had a little lean to when she went to the rehab. But her mental status is off. She the thoughts of my father and my father's death really did do a number on her mental status. She still knows who I am and knows who her children are. But when I tried to leave tonight, I had to sneak out of her room. I wanted to say something. I could have stayed, but I'm cramping. I've got to pack a bag. It's telling you about my personal business. But I went up there to visit my mom at 1 o'clock. It's almost midnight now. What has happened? She went back into the hospital. She was having problems with her oxygen. The nurse that comes over every week and checks her saw that she was having problems with her oxygen levels. And she was also... What was going on? Her kidneys were not acting well. So when she was conscious when they took her out of the home. She was kept on, they had to carry her out. She kept on saying, "Oh Lord, oh Lord, oh Lord." But when she got to the hospital, I got there by ambulance, I drove. They had to run so many tests on her and place her on a ventilator. She stayed in a coma for 5-6 days. For 6 days, maybe five, I don't know. And then she got the vent out a day later. So there was a lot of praying, and my family really does. I'm a prime example of their prayers. And I know she's a strong woman. She's a tough cookie. One of the things she told me tonight, she was having some problems with her because she just got into the rehab last night at 9, so they were behind and on getting her medication in. So she was feeling kind of weak as the day went on because I was just like, okay, trying to keep calm and cool and trusting God. I was waiting, and they never did bring her medicine when I thought it should have been, in my mind, when I thought it should have been wrong. She got a little weak in her talk and weaken her movements to me. So I rushed out and I said, I saw her eye nurse and I said, look, either you find her medicine, find her somebody's medication, since hers is still waiting to come, or I'ma call 911. So she, I don't know what she did, or I don't know what went on, whether it was another patient's medication or whatever, but her medication, the nurse did give her medication. So she got to feeling better a little bit, but then she got sleepy, so she wanted melatonin and she wanted some of the, well, she really wanted some wine. She was asking for wine when she was in the hospital. She got mad because I wouldn't give her no wine, and she got mad because the nurse wouldn't give her no wine. So, she got the nurse brought her tonight at the rehab, brought her some melatonin, and she was then. I could have left earlier, but that's my mama. I want to make sure my mama's okay. So, I stayed there to see if the melatonin was going to kick in. And it didn't, but it did, because that's how I snuck out, tiptoed out the room. She kept on telling me that I can go put on my pajamas, meaning her pajamas. I'm little her, but I'm little her, and she's mom. She's not a great big old woman, but this southern mama, country girl, came to the city, did all this magnificent stuff. I'm little mama, and she's, so her stuff would have, it wouldn't fit right on me, right on me. I wouldn't feel that comfortable in her stuff. So, I snuck on out. I want to be in my bed. I'm on my cycle, or I'm coming on my cycle. I want to sleep in my bed and get me some real nice rest, because I gotta wake up tomorrow to another busy day. With everything happening, my faucet in my bathroom bathtub is it's not going all the way off, and it's the hot water. So, yeah, that's going on. No one's life is easy. No human's life is easy. If you're living and breathing, life is gonna bring you a challenge. And you can say it ain't hurting you, or you can pull through, but it's okay to cry every now and then, or take a deep breath, or be by yourself for a while. I love being by myself. I love it. I do have help. I do have a support team. I do have a lovely partner in my life. And he is helping so much. He is helping so much. But it's a lot going on. And it isn't a time to break down and cry and moan and groan and say you can't take it. Because if you couldn't take it, God wouldn't put you through it. If you couldn't take it, the God, the ancestors, whoever you believe in, if you couldn't take it, you wouldn't be in the situation. But since you're in the situation, somebody on the other side knew you can deal with it. So you have to do what you have to do. Put your big girl panties on, put your big boy panties on, and do it. But on the other hand, I'm waiting on my editor to get back with me on my book. So it can be out and going. I told her to hold off and kind of, she always calls, or she'll call every now and then periodically and be like, Yolanda, we're going to set up a time, we're going to set up a time. But then she's so backed up with these other people, with these other writers, other authors that she's trying to get out, because they have, their books are, go along with the month and the season, like a Christmas. November is domestic, well, I'm just saying, I don't know, but like domestic violence time and all this kind of stuff, and breast cancer time and all this. So she's trying to put those, get those going as well. But my birthday, my 42nd birthday, is on the 15th of January. So yes, I would like my book to be out before or around the time of my birth date, so I can have another weekend to celebrate. So that could be an exhale moment for me. My book is called The Red Strike, and it's under Cookbook Publishing. And it kind of tells the story about how my mom ended up in the situation she's in before she got, before all the sickness leading back to, well, you got to read the book. I'm not going to tell you what it's all about. But, yeah, I haven't been on for a while. I'm here now. Thank you for watching. Life isn't easy. If it were easy, everyone would get reborn. If it were easy, you wouldn't be motivated. If it were easy, you wouldn't have nothing to talk about. Nothing to push you. So, this is life. And you gotta keep on smiling through it. You gotta look boldly before everyone. And they don't know what the hell you're going through, but you know what the hell you're going through. And my sister and my oldest nephew feel that, well, my sister is not talking to me because she's still not talking because she feels that she should be in control. My oldest nephew, I don't know what in the hell he come from with this on his mind, but he feels like that he's being left out of, and he's not being included in the health, and you know, he should have some kind of part. Now, you're the grandson. You're not the son. You were, if you had anything going, you were my father's responsibility. And what you did with my father, you went to court, or there was a court issue, and my father became guardian of you until you were 18. You're not gonna come over and bring that bullshit you put me through with my mama. Hell no. I know people. I know spirits. Don't fool with me. Not about my mama. But anyway, I love you guys. Thank you for watching. I'll see you later. Keep you updated. Bye-bye. I'm helping people. If you got a problem with what I said, she's putting all her mother's business down the street and making her mother's information public. Look here, honey. You take you and your skeletons in graveyards somewhere and go sit down somewhere. You got most of all up in the way, and you hiding shit Why are you talking about other people's stuff? Because your life is that bad and you feel so embarrassed by what you have done, what you have caused and made happen, cause and effect, karma, that you can't share it. You cannot release it. So you want to hide behind closed doors, like you have clean hands, but your hands just black and terrible. It's all get out. And it's crust, and you got so much crust on your hands from doing all the stuff you have done. Get out of my face. I'm sharing what I'm going through, because others may be going through the same thing too. So I'm helping someone. I'm growing my page this time, little by little. If you don't like it, you know what to do. The door. Bye.